Broadcasters Association, Union Pacific Foundation, Boise State University's School of Public Service, Idaho Cable Broadband Association, Associated Taxpayers of Idaho, Association of Idaho Cities, University of Idaho's McClure Center for Public Policy Research, with additional support from the Idaho Public Television Endowment. Funding for Idaho in Session is provided by the Idaho State Broadcasters Association, Union Pacific Foundation, Boise State University's School of Public Service, Idaho Cable Broadband Association, Associated Taxpayers of Idaho, Association of Idaho Cities, University of Idaho's McClure Center for Public Policy Research, with additional support from the Idaho Public Television Endowment. Funding for Idaho in Session is provided by the Idaho State Broadcasters Association, Union Pacific Foundation, Boise State University's School of Public Service, Idaho Cable Broadband Association, Associated Taxpayers of Idaho, Association of Idaho Cities, University of Idaho's McClure Center for Public Policy Research, with additional support from the Idaho Public Television Endowment. Presiding for Idaho in Session is provided by the Idaho State Broadcasters Association, Union Pacific Foundation, Boise State University's School of Public Service, Idaho Cable Broadband Association, Associated Taxpayers of Idaho, Association of Idaho Cities, University of Idaho's McClure Center for Public Policy Research, with additional support from the Idaho Public Television Endowment. Funding for Idaho in Session is provided by the Idaho State Broadcasters Association, Union Pacific Foundation, Boise State University's School of Public Service, Idaho Cable Broadband Association, Associated Taxpayers of Idaho, Association of Idaho Cities, University of Idaho's McClure Center for Public Policy Research, with additional support from the Idaho Public Television Endowment. Funding for Idaho in Session is provided by the Idaho State Broadcasters Association, Union Pacific Foundation, Boise State University's School of Public Service, Idaho Cable Broadband Association, Associated Taxpayers of Idaho, Association of Idaho Cities, University of Idaho's McClure Center for Public Policy Research, with additional support from the Idaho Public Television Endowment. Thank you. Funding for Idaho in Session is provided by the Idaho.
Joe, you're very particular. How's that sound? It's sometimes on the back.
Okay. Then. Yeah, testing. It's working. Test 1, 2, test.
Okay. All right. I hereby call this meeting the Idaho presidential electors order at 12:30. 12 noon. This meeting is being live streamed public to Idaho Public Television Center. So this occasion marks an important.
Thanks, Joe. I better do that again. I hereby call this meeting the Idaho Presidential Electors to order. At 12 noon, this meeting is being live streamed through Idaho Public Television's Idaho in Session page. What we're doing here today marks an endpoint in Idaho's presidential electoral process enumerated in Title II of the United States Constitution. It marks a reminder of how our democratic republic was envisioned by our forefathers. We should celebrate the incredible Idaho turnout and all the efforts of our elections officials, both state and local, volunteers, and all the voters to express the will of the people in a safe and secure manner. Let me introduce Idaho's duly elected presidential electors who have received their certificates of election signed by the Secretary of State, myself. They are Rod Beck, Raul Labrador, Janice McGeehan, and Melinda Smizer. Secretary of State, who is the Chief Elections Officer of the state, is present and will now distribute and collect the ballots that will then be delivered to me. I will then read off each vote while the Secretary of State tallies the votes. Mr. Secretary. For each elector, once you've finished voting, I would ask you press the button at the base of your microphone, right here, and this will cause your microphone to light up red and indicate to the Secretary of State that you're ready to have him collect your ballots. Once the Secretary of State has collected your ballots, you may make a few remarks, if you wish, by using the microphone in front of you. Mr. Beck.
I'm ready.
Okay. You have some remarks?
I do. A few remarks.
A few brief remarks.
A few brief remarks. First off, I would like to commend the members of the Idaho Legislature and the governor and our election officials in Ada County. It would be Phil McGrane and it would be Lawerence Denney on the state level. We had an unprecedented turnout in this election, and if the rest of the country could learn, take some lessons and learn from the state of Idaho, I think every person in the state of Idaho that was legally entitled to vote was able to get a ballot and was able to vote. And I don't think there was any illegal votes in the state of Idaho, and I think that's because of the tremendous job that our election officials did. And I was particularly pleased with the special session where you passed legislation that allowed the clerks to start tabulating the absentee votes. That made it efficient. They could get it done fast. And so I want to commend all the public officials, the legislature, the governor, and the Secretary of State and his people. We had a smooth running operation, and our operation is trusted.
Thank you, Mr. Beck. Mr. Labrador.
Thank you, Governor. Thank you, Mr. Secretary. It's an honor to be here with you, and I proudly cast my vote for Donald J. Trump as president and Michael R. Pence as vice president of the United States. I have had the honor to work and associate with both of these men, and I'm grateful that our nation was led by them for the last 4 years. Their election 4 years ago was great for this nation, led to the first time in a generation that our country did not start or expand on a foreign conflict, and facilitated the appointment of three great justices to the Supreme Court. And today I am proud to cast my vote for both of these men.
J. Janice McGeehan, Lieutenant Governor.
Thank you, Governor Little. I can remember so well the day that Donald J. Trump made his announcement to run for president. I was dressed and ready to go to work, and I thought, well, I'll sit and listen to him talk for a few minutes. He went on for more than an hour, and I listened the whole time, and what he had to say really spoke to my heart. He spoke about a political establishment that had become out of touch with the people of America, only working for those who were elite or politically connected. And he sold my heart, as well as millions of Americans across the country, on this dream that he was going to return America to the great country that it always has been and always will be. Our president's accomplishments are so many to be listed, but I do want to talk about some of them. He was under our president, women's unemployment rate recently reached the lowest rate in 65 years. Under the president's tax reform rate, small businesses across the country now have the lowest top marginal tax rate in more than 80 years. We have a record number of regulations eliminated, confirmed more circuit court judges than any other new administration, including three Supreme Court justices, withdrew from the horrible one-sided Iran deal, and he moved the U.S. Embassy to Jerusalem. So many great accomplishments of our president. I wish to thank the people of Idaho for their overwhelming support of President Donald J. Trump, and I'm happy to cast my vote in support of Donald J. Trump for president and Mike Pence as vice president.
Thank you, Mrs. Meiser.
Thank you, Governor, and thank you for letting me be a elector to represent Idaho to vote for President Donald Trump and Vice President Mike Pence. I am proud today to be able to cast my vote. Donald Trump started his campaign, and during his campaign, he made a lot of promises, and he kept those promises. And he had the courage to stand up to other nations. He brought energy independence to the United States of America. We now are helping out people who are low income because everybody buys gas, and therefore making sure that our energy, that we're independent from other countries, is really important. He also had the courage to do many other things that other presidents just go along with. We know that in America, it is the greatest country to live in. That's why everybody's wanting to live here. The tax cuts, he supported also the deregulation, and I want to give credit to our current governor, Governor Little, because Idaho was one of the most deregulated states in the nation, and that's why we had one of the lowest unemployment rates. So first of all, we know that we're conservatives, we're a conservative state, we're a red state, and we're fortunate. But it takes grassroots, it takes hard work, it takes fair elections. And we know in Idaho, we know how to work. And we know that we want to continue our way of life for our children and our grandchildren. So I am proud today to be able to have cast my vote as an elector for Donald Trump and for Vice President Mike Pence. Go Donald.
Secretary of State will collect the ballots. Suspense is kind of gone at this point in time. Mr. Secretary, are you ready to tally the votes?
I'm ready.
The first ballot is for Donald J. Trump for president. The second ballot is for Donald J. Trump as president. The third ballot is for Donald J. Trump as president. And the fourth ballot is for Donald J. Trump as president. In the vice presidential race, the first ballot is for Michael R. Pence. The second ballot is for Michael R. Pence. The third ballot is for Michael R. Pence, and the fourth ballot is for Michael R. Pence. The Secretary of State will now distribute 6 certificates of votes to the electors for signature, starting at one end, and each elector handling the document down to the next elector. Deputy Secretary of State Jason Hancock, who is the State Elections Director, will receive the completed certificates at the far end of the row. Got them all, Jason?
Yep.
Okay, the Secretary of State will attach the certificates of votes to the certificates of ascertainment previously prepared and signed by the Secretary of State myself, and will distribute these paired certificates as followed. 1 copy to the Honorable Michael R. Pence, President of the U.S. Senate, United States Senate. 2 copies to David Ferrario, the Archivist for the United States. 2 copies to the Secretary of State, the State of Idaho, and 1 copy to Judge David Nye, the Chief Judge of the Federal District Court for the District of Idaho. I want to thank all the electors for their service, the presidential electors for the State of Idaho. Oh, excuse me. Mr. Secretary, would you like to make a comment?
Very, very, very briefly, I would like to just say that the code, the Idaho code, representing the electors was passed in 1899 and has been changed once in 1980, and that was because of the pay for the electors, and I don't know what it was. It was probably at that time, it's probably feed for their horses. So,
well, it's $15 now.
So it's 15, yeah. Now, so it doesn't even feed their horses.
Okay, with that, thank you, Mr. Secretary. But I want to thank the electors for their service to the State of Idaho. Your work has been completed, your duties discharged, and the 2020 meeting of the Idaho electors is adjourned. Thank you very much.
Thank you.